Hi, my name is Karthik from Design School by Wpalgoridm, and in this video, I want to show you how you can customize your WordPress post grids or your Elementor Pro post grids with help of a free plugin called Elementor Custom Skin. It's really simple, and what I'm essentially talking about is that when you use Elementor Pro's post widget, you can customize the look of the widget just a little bit. Maybe you can exclude or include a few fields, but you cannot change the design of the loop. Now, this whole thing is called a grid, and each individual item, so this is an individual item, and this is called a loop. So loop is the thing that repeats itself in a loop. That repeats itself in a grid. So we're essentially trying to design the loop so that the entire grid will be affected. So that's what we're going to do. And to do that, all you need to do is to head over to plugins, and from the WordPress repository, just search for LE custom skin. And it's this one by dudaster.com. It's this one, install and activate that. And once you do that, by the way, this works with Elementor Pro. Bear that in mind. Of course, the Pro post widget is a part of Elementor Pro. Now, when you head over to Theme Builder, you have a new entry called loop. I'll just click on that, and I'm going to create a new loop. I'll call it my posts loop, and I'll just click on create template. We've already discussed this while using custom post types. Now I have a problem. It says that content area is not found. What can I do about it? Well, I don't know if it's a problem with the theme or Elementor or the plugin, but a simple fix of this would be just come back after creating the template, just click on edit, and under here, change the template from default template to Elementor canvas or Elementor full width. So that should most probably fix your content not found problem, just like that. So that's a pro tip. Again, if you go to Elementor's website, they have suggested changing your theme and doing some stuff, but I found this way easier. Just change the layout by going back and clicking on edit, right? I'll show that again. I'll exit to dashboard and click on theme builder. Instead of clicking on edit with Elementor, you just click on edit, and under template, change it from default template to Elementor canvas or Elementor full width. And that should most possibly fix your content not found problem, just like this. Now you're free to create our posts loop. This might also be a problem or the compatibility issue with Elementor custom skin, but don't worry, you know how to fix it. Now I just want to customize the look of my loop, right? The individual item. What I'm going to do is to use my flipbox widget to design my loop. Since Elementor Pro has dynamic options, you can quite easily do that. Now the front of the loop, the front title will be my post title. You can click on the dynamic tags button and select the dynamic tag that I want for that. And it shows my post 1, 2, 3. Now the description, I just want to be my post excerpt. Just click here. On the back, I'll just click on this and I'll change it to author name. And maybe I'll say read the post. And click here. Just change it to read now. And the link, or after change the link here, I'll click on dynamic tag and I'll point it to post URL. Update. You can simply add condition, but you can simply click on add condition and include no conditions. Even this will work because we are creating a loop. It doesn't matter. So once we created our loop, you can reload this page, or if you're creating a new page, just drag in your Elementor post widget. I'll just click on the post widget, click on skin, choose custom, and you can choose my post loop. Just like that, whatever we've created right now, each of the item is replaced by the loop design, and the data is dynamic. So it's getting individual data. It's getting post title, post excerpt. And when I hover over it, it shows the author name and it says read the post. Read the post is the only static data that we have here. You can customize the loop totally any way you want. So you can go to settings. Maybe you can use the zoom effect. I'll try using that. I'll update the loop. Now I have to reload my post grid. And just like that, the new effect is being applied. And it's really neat, right? You can also control the post width. So you can click on the section of the loop. And here you can change the content width of the loop. If you want it bigger, if you want it smaller, if you want it compact. So just the height of the loop item, update. Again, reload this page. And it gets its properties from whatever template that you've defined. You can use maybe other elements. Maybe I can use the featured image as a background. You can use dynamic tag and use featured image for the whole section. Something like that. We'll see how that will look like in our post grid. So it looks something like this. So behind there's our background image. But how do you reuse this post grid that you created? See, it's simple. Just right click and say save as global. And you say global post grid. Hit save. And this grid will be available across your website. So whenever you create a new page with Elementor, I'll just click on edit with Elementor to show you. Since it's global widget, it's accessible everywhere and you change it every once and the change is reflected across Elementor canvas. I'll just click here. Now there's a column called global. I click on that. There's our global post grid. Just drag it and instantly all our posts are visible. I'll just uncheck use custom grid option and there's our custom grid that we've created using the custom loop. So this is really neat and this is how you can customize the look of your post grid item. Posts widget is a part of Elementor Pro. You can get it from the link in the description. That's it for now. And not just posts, you can pull in any data. It doesn't just stand for post. You can pull in any data, it doesn't matter. You can pull in custom post types. So it doesn't really matter what kind of post that you pick. So under query, you can select posts, pages, landing pages, or whatever custom post types that you have on your website. It doesn't matter. It'll just get the skin from the custom loop and apply it to any of the custom post types. That's it for now. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up. We'll catch you in the next one. Until then, peace.